cacophony. Whenever visitors want a tour, it usually falls to me. I never say no. I still derive the same pleasure from it. I come here so many times a year that my wife once said to me, one day you'll drop dead on top of the dune. But deep down, she'll be pleased that I'm not dirtying her floors.
A hill of sand deposited between Land Forest and Arcachon Bay, the dune of Pilat impresses with its golden slopes. Every year, up to 2 million visitors brave the elements to play at being nomads and climb 110 meters to its peak. The dune is named after the Gascon word for hillock and stretches over 616 meters from east to west and over 3 kilometers from north to south. Jean Lannes, the man in the beret, is an expert on the place. He shares his love of the highest sand dune in Europe with tourists.
I'm a storyteller. I take people for a walk and tell them stories about my country and the history of the dune, because it's not just a pile of sand randomly placed at the entrance to the bay, or no. My love affair with the dune started a long time ago. I'm not going to lie, I've been enamored with it for over 30 years. We've been close for 30 years. She's a very young old lady. Because she is 2,000 years old, perhaps less, but 2,000 years in the history of the Earth is recent history.
This coastal region was inhabited in Neolithic times, but the dune has gradually covered it over, all the while burying astonishing secrets in its depths.
In the time that I've known it, it hasn't given much away. No. We don't know what lies beneath it. Legend has it that there are villages buried underneath it. But there are no villages under the dune. You don't hear church bells ringing on a stormy night. No. It's still active, still moving, still alive. I come here all the time, all year round, in winter and in summer, and it never looks the same. It changes its appearance, its color, and its shape. The wind sculpts this great lady, who appears to be immobile and asleep. She is creeping towards the forest, swallowing up the pine trees. They can't take any more of it. It's killing them. There's no other word for it. She does as she pleases.
Despite numerous attempts in the past to stabilize it, the dune of Pilat remains mobile. It keeps on rolling, defying the humans who try to restrain it.
Listen, you're at the foot of the dune. I'm going to tell you a story, and it's a true story. I'm not talking about the Middle Ages. I'm talking about exactly 12 years ago. You see those oak trees over there? Under those oak trees, there was a restaurant. I have a photograph of it in my file. You could walk round it. The terrace was under the oak trees, which had been half swallowed up by the dunes. You could walk round it from behind, and there, where that woman in blue is, on the stairs, that was where you started climbing the dune. It was 50 meters further away. Yes, the dune is advancing towards the forest by 3 to 5 meters a year. Towards the forest. It's the wind. It's the wind that's driving it forwards. It's the wind that is sculpting the dune. I'm going to show you the old photograph from a newspaper, and you'll see the restaurant. It's hard to make it out, but you can just see it. Where is that restaurant? Here somewhere. Here it is. Look at the restaurant there. It's half buried there. Can you see the restaurant? There were tall pine trees. Look, there were tall pine trees behind the oak trees, and they've all been swallowed up. The restaurant wasn't left to be buried. It was dismantled. Yeah. There was a hut selling postcards, too.
Climbing this imposing natural edifice using calf power alone isn't as easy as it looks. Underfoot, you've got a huge volume of sand, 60 million cubic meters of silica.
We finally made it to the top of the dune. Look at that. The yellow of the dune is wedged between the blue of the ocean and the green of the forest. How could that yellow not be beautiful? The sky colors the dune. It changes color depending on the time of day and the weather. It goes from blonde to gray to chestnut, changing color all the time. This sand doesn't come from the ocean down there. It comes from much further away. If you rub it gently in your palm with your finger, you'll see that the grains are perfectly round. It's fluvial sand. The rivers brought it here. It was transported here by water. And it's rolling around in the water that made it round. If you go to the Sahara, the grains of sand are pointed because the wind has knocked the stones against one another. It's the water that's made it smooth. And if you look at the colors, it's predominantly yellow. That's the silica. That is why the dune is yellow, because there are many more yellow grains than anything else. But look closely, they're not all yellow. Some of them are black, that's mica, and some are white and transparent, that's quartz. They're also gray and brown grains, they're feldspar. If you were to stick these grains of sand together, you'd get a rock. Granite. And where does granite come from? It comes from Brittany and the Massif Central. Then it rolls around in the Loire and in the Garonne, and it goes from a boulder to a stone to a pebble to shingle, finally reaching the water's edge. And at the water's edge, it becomes a grain of sand. And the strong current sends the sand south from the Aquitaine to Cap Ferret. When it gets to Cap Ferret, it thinks, that's it, I've arrived at my destination. But no, Cap Ferret is eroding 2 to 5 meters a year. So it's sent packing and jumps into the sea at Tulinque in the Bay of Aquin, finally arriving at the foot of the dune. And then it thinks, I may as well climb it. But no. At the foot of the dune, the grains of sand are 0.4 or 0.5 millimeters wide. Here at the top, they're only 0.2 millimeters wide. So it has to wait to be rolled around in the sea for thousands of years before finally being blown to the top of the dune by the wind, and then towards the forest, which is being swallowed up. That's why it's there. Whenever visitors want a tour, it usually falls to me. I never say no. I still derive the same pleasure from it. I come here so many times a year that my wife once said to me, one day you'll drop dead on top of the dune. But deep down, she'll be pleased that I'm not dirtying her floors. I'm very happy on the dune. I think I'm a bit addicted to it.
Magnetic and powerful, the dune of Pilat is constantly transforming itself, but it never disappears. This ancient sand is like gold, that precious metal also thought to be everlasting. ¶¶